well, the Audi's all set up with a bed in the back. And I've got the V11 packed in. Over in that corner over there. All the gear for the trip to Adelaide. It's going to be epic. It's 4:15, 4:16 on Sunday. I'm just about to hit the road to Adelaide in my Audi as a range test and see what the fuel economy is like now. I'm going to set it into efficiency mode over here, which I've never run it in efficiency mode before. Individual, can't really set it on individual efficiency. So if I just go with their efficiency, and let's see how we go with the fuel economy. Yeah, the amount of choices you have here is just too much, really. But I've never run it in efficiency, so let's see what fuel economy we get. I've got 1 kilometre on the clock since I've come from the servo, 76.575, it's 4:17 now. So let's do it. So we're aiming at 10 Briar Road, Felixstowe in South Australia, just that's in Adelaide. It says fastest route, 1 day, 4 hours fastest. 24, 25, 26, 27, 28. Well, I've actually done it in 26 hours, but I don't think I'll be trying to do that this time. 1,676 miles. Stopped at the bottom of Green Mount Hill, and this fuel economy is showing 6.5 litres per 100 at this stage, and that's just getting out of the city. That's the lowest I've ever, like, that's the sort of range what I would get on the country road. 6.6 just went up to because I just accelerated out of there, but it seems like it's got a lot less immediate acceleration. You know, it's just managing it a lot nicely. Fuel economy, I think. So interesting to see. I reckon I'm going to get less than 6 litres per 100 kilometres on this trip, which is close to 50 mile to the gallon in the old measure, which is pretty incredible for a diesel that's got more power than a V8. 600 newton meters, 650 newton meters of torque, and 235 kilowatts. And I'm going to get less than 6 litres per 100 kilometres on this trip, I'm pretty sure. Well, at the top of Green Mount, it looks like we've gone up to 7.7 litres per 100, so that's, yeah, going uphill for quite a steep gradient, sitting on 85 in the 80 zone, or 83. Well, 250 kilometres in, we're at 6.7 litres per 100. It went down to 6.6, but then it's gone back up to 6.7, I think maybe because it's a bit of a headwind, or there was back there a bit, but 6.7 is still pretty good. Well, I've just cracked 400 k's just east of Southern Cross. I think about 120 or 130 to Coolgardie. And the full moon's just come up over there. It's looking pretty awesome. And so far I'm down at 6.5 litres per 100. So far on the trip, I'm just hanging behind this car here because it's a lot less stressful than having to look way ahead. I only have to look, I'm probably sitting back about 100 metres from him, I reckon, or 80 metres. He's sitting on 113, which is ideal. Otherwise, I'd be just going on my own, probably sitting on about 105. Little sweeper in front, so it's all good. Yep, well, sitting on this car, he's doing 113 now, he's doing 105 a little bit earlier, but it's just easier to drive behind someone sitting, you know, 80 metres, 90 metres back. Just, I don't have to scan so far ahead, and if he sees anything, I'll see his brake lights. So, yeah, it's just pretty cruisy. It's a lot more comfortable just sitting rather than behind someone at night rather than driving. This speed, I'll be going a lot slower actually. I'll be probably just doing about 100-105, but he's in the Land Cruiser, so he's okay, and I'm just sitting behind him. But interestingly, it's telling me that I've still got 550 kilometres of fuel left, and I've done 500, so maybe I'm going to get 1,050 kilometres out of a tank, out of a 65 litre tank, and it's showing 6.4 litres per 100 at the moment. That's the average so far for the trip. I've got 2 hours and 6 minutes to Norseman. Should get there at 11:45 if I don't stop. But I might stop, but while I'm sitting behind this car, I might as well just keep going. 126 miles, what's that, about 180 k's to go. So, yeah, hour and three quarters or something like that. But whilst I'm sitting behind this car, I'm just going to keep sitting behind it, because it's a lot easier to drive like that. It's a full moon anyway, so full moon is going to make it so much more visible for roos and stuff, and they'll be able to see us a lot better, so fingers crossed, hopefully we're all good. Coming into Coolgardie here, still got more than half a tank, and I've done 530 k's, 540 nearly. I'm turning off to Norseman now, so that's another 170 k's, plenty of fuel to get there. Might even go on to Belladonna if I've got still enough fuel, but I probably should fill up at Norseman, it'll be cheaper. Well, it's telling me I've got 500 k's in the tank. I've just done 609 k's, so telling me that maybe I can get 1100 k's out of a tank. Down to 6.3 now, but I'm just cruising at 100. There's no car in front of me, I'm just taking it a bit easy. It just gives you a bit more reaction time for anything that decides to jump out in front of you. Yeah, I'm just coming up behind this big road train now, and I'm thinking if once he gets over this hill, if he's sitting on 102 or something like that, which they usually do, I'm just going to tuck in behind him as well and just sit back a little bit. Just cruise along behind him. Makes it easy to drive. Well, I've arrived at Norseman, and it's telling me I've got 430 kilometres left in the tank. I've done 698.5, so 700 k's, and I can still do 430. So that's 1130, and as you can see, the fuel tank there is showing it's probably only just under half, or 44.33 litres for 698.5 k's. It's got to be pretty good, doesn't it? We have coffee on the go. Drive on for another hour or so, and then call it a night. Jump in here for a bit of a sleep and then get up early. 40 miles or 600 k's to Eucla. 7 hours to Eucla. So I won't have to fill out up until Eucla, maybe not even then. Maybe get on to Nullabor or somewhere. But anyway, I'll be stopping a couple of times. It's telling me I've got a 1,010 k range now. So it'll be interesting to see what the fuel economy is now that I'm just out on the open highway right from the start, instead of going up Greenmount Hill and stuff, out of all the traffic. Well, it's nearly 4:30, and I think I got here at 1:30, so I've had about at least 2.5 hours sleep, I reckon. But about to hit the road again. Sun's about to rise. Belladonna. Only, well, there's still a fair bit to go. Well, nothing's open at Belladonna till 6, so I'm keeping on going. I thought I might get a coffee, but I might have to stop up here and make myself one. Well, we've got coffee on the go. Found a truck stop. About 120, 150 k's on. I'm averaging 7 at this stage because I'm into a bit of a headwind here. It's coming from over there straight into me. So I think my fuel economy has been stuffed up by that. A little bit anyway. I'm still getting 7, which is pretty good. coast. So we're going to have a look here and I'll get around him in a minute. He's sitting on 100 though, which is towing a trailer at 100, he's really fucking keen.
Passed on the bike, towing a trailer just back there. I just stopped. Here he is. Wayne is his name. Wayne. Just gave you some nice peaches.
Peaches? Apricots.
Apricots, yeah. Good.
They were from Merin.
Yeah, right.
Yep.
So, yeah, we just had a bit of a rest stop and we're back on the way.
That's it.
Got braking on it. Trailer braking, mate.
Yeah. Just braked under there.
Yeah, right. This is a gold wing. I think it's... say 1800?
Yep, 1800. I call an F6B, so it's a flat 6.
Flat 6?
Yep.
So wow, okay. Oh yeah, right. Are they, all the gold wings flats, are they?
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, right.
Yep.
Mate, that's a boxer motor.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yep.
This will get me to Adelaide.
Well, we almost have sunrise, and I'm getting 6.4, 6.5, because there's no wind. Just almost a quarter gusta. I'm just getting off the freeway into Adelaide, so I'm going to pull into a circle.
The final result of this test of the Audi in economy mode, the Audi A7, the Bi-Turbo Diesel, driven in economy mode, from Perth to Adelaide, 2,628 kilometres. Total litres used was 181.98, nearly 182 litres. Total cost just over $400, $413.40. I got 6.92 litres per 100 for the whole trip average. And like I said yesterday, I was up in the mid sevens because I was hitting in a headwind all day, probably about a 15 knot headwind all day, sitting on 115. So getting less than 7 litres per 100 is pretty good, because on the way back from Sydney originally I got 7.43. So it's over 40 miles to the gallon, which is pretty incredible, because back in 1979 I drove a Datsun 120Y with a couple of mates across the Nullabor. And the 120Y is a 1200 four cylinder with very little power, top speed of 60. We thought we did good to get 42 miles to the gallon. Well, I reckon I've got just as good a mileage in this 3-litre twin turbo diesel with about four times as much power. Pretty pretty amazing to get that sort of fuel economy from a car with this much power. Very impressive indeed.